70% in patients with receiving anti-cancer treatment and about 64% in patients with advanced metastatic diseases. Now, to start this session, I would like to invite on the dais as chairpersons, Dr. Sabya Sakshi Das, unfortunately he is not here, Dr. Pratibha Jain Shah, please madam. Dr. Pratibha, she is an eminent teacher and examiner. She did her MBBS and MD from Department of Anesthesiology, NSCB Medical College, Jabalpur. She did her CE residency from All India Institute, Delhi. Right now, she is working as an associate professor in Medical College, Raipur. And her field of interest is managing patients with low back pain. Welcome, madam. Our next chairperson would be Dr. Abhijit Dam. Welcome, sir. He did his MBBS in 1990 from Kolkata. Did his MD in 1995 of palliative care. Welcome, sir. Now we have to start our lectures and I'll hand over to our chairpersons to continue from here.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thanks, ma'am, for the introduction. The first speaker in this session is Dr. Sushma Bhatnagar, and I think I invite madam, and there is no need of introduction. Everybody knows about her. Our topic is cancer pain, what is different?
Okay, before I start the slides, I want to ask you whether there is a difference between cancer and non-cancer pain patients. How many you say yes? How many say that all the patients are same? So patient is patient, but the topic is given that they, I have to differentiate cancer and non-cancer pain. Patient are always same. It's a chronic pain, whether it is cancer or whether it is non-cancer. When patient is having osteoarthritis, patient is having pain because of other diseases, we are less sympathetic, we are less sincere about his pain. It is not like this, both the pains are same. Even the cancer pain is severe and excruciating, and sometimes patient with chronic pain also suffers a lot. I will give you an example that a lady comes to you, she was operated with the modified radical mastectomy around 12 years back. And now she is coming to you with the pain in the tingling and numbness and pain in his toe and fingers. And she is saying that this is disturbing and this is really destroying and this is really deteriorating my quality of life. I cannot do, I cannot help, I cannot hold anything, I cannot catch anything, and this is really troublesome. So where you will put this lady, cancer pain or non-cancer pain? Similarly, one example, we will take one patient who is operated with for carcinoma lung, and the surgeon did thoracotomy, and absolutely now patient received chemotherapy, patient received radiotherapy, patient is disease free, but after 10 years, in every follow up he was saying that there is a pain in the scar site, there is a pain in the scar site, and after 10 years also, after 10 years the pain has become so severe that she is not able to wear the clothes, and she comes to my pain clinic without clothes, just covering with this thing, covering with the sari, and she says that I cannot even wear clothes and I am having severe pain in the scar site. She's saying that only in the scar site. So again, we will consider this as a cancer pain or a non-cancer pain. So this becomes a problem for us to differentiate cancer and non-cancer pain. So there are, how we will differentiate, this is the difference. How much time I have? 15 minutes. I will take 15 minutes. So, cancer and non-cancer pain. Non-cancer pain, non-malignant pain can be many cause. Cancer is only one cause. But when we talk about cancer, then we start talking about death, we start talking about suffering, and we start talking about everything. So, but the pain is same in both the patients. So chronic pain, when we will say chronic pain, when patient, any etiology, whether it is malignant or non-malignant, any chronic condition, it can be diabetes mellitus, it can be multiple sclerosis, it can be anything, it can be cancer. And extending beyond the duration which should have been subsided. If patient's pain would have been subsided, the example I have given, the thoracotomy scar, if pain would have been subsided, should have been subsided within a week's time when patient is getting discharged. But pain is still there after 15 years on the scar site. So that is a chronic pain. So when pain takes the longer time than the expected time to subside, then it becomes a chronic pain. And when it becomes more than 6 months, we consider it as a chronic pain. Okay? Whatever you say, chronic pain always affects the... So learning objective of this lecture will be, I will not go into the detail of pathophysiology, but we will assess how to assess chronic and persistent, chronic malignant and non-malignant pain, how to recognize pain relief as an important aspect of quality of life, whether it is malignant or non-malignant, what is the impact of persistent pain, and what is the relevance of WHO analgesic letter in terms of cancer pain and in terms of non-malignant pain. So whatever you say, this slide will remain the same. This will be the important slide for pain management, whether it is malignant, whether it is non-malignant. You have to have this history record, see the records available, investigate if required, otherwise don't investigate. Confirm the site where is the pain, identify the cause why the pain is happening. In cases of cancer pain, whether it is nociceptive or neuropathic. In cases of non-malignant pain, again, whether it is nociceptive and neuropathic. But whether the cancer pain is because of the tissue involvement, because the tissue is compressing the nerve, because tissue is stretching the nerve. So everything will depend, your treatment will depend on the when you will identify the cause. And then finally, whether it is malignant or non-malignant, you have to establish the trust. Developing trust is the key of success of your management. All patients can become completely all right if you will develop a trust between you and your patient. So I will continue the example. I will give you the two examples, and I will not go into the slides because slides, I told that my laptop was not working, my pen drive was not working. Since yesterday, everything was corrupt with this laptop, that laptop. So I have prepared the slide on the spot. So we will go through the slides afterwards. I will give you the two examples. One example I have already given, whether this lady is chronic pain, cancer pain or non-cancer pain. And then I will give you an example of a boy. He's 30 years old. He was a performer. He was a musician, and he used to perform to all over the world. And he used to give big performance to all over the world. Everywhere he used to go. And last performance before he came to me was he has given 3 years back in Milan, where 50,000 people have attended that his performance. So he was a big... He was a big shot in Bombay. He is a Jaipur based boy. He went to Mumbai. And then finally in Mumbai, you know, when he was 1.5 years old, he was having meningomyelocele. And he was operated for meningomyelocele, and then he developed tethered cord syndrome because of meningomyelocele. So in tethered cord syndrome, there is no ball and bladder. They are not able to sense the ball and bladder senses. So he used to evacuate his bladder regularly after every 4 hours, 5 hours, because there was no senses of filling of the bladder, and he used to manually evacuate every day. This was his daily routine, and he used to do everything of his own. In spite of this habit, he was doing very well. He was a very smart boy. He was doing very well in his life. And, you know, he was earning well. He was very popular. And finally, 3 years back, one surgeon told him that I can operate on you and your senses will come back. So bladder and bowel senses will come back. So he has operated on him. And once he was operated for the back surgery, he started having pain. And pain was so severe and excruciating, because slowly he went, and when he came to me, there was a big big file with him. He went to all possible doctors from everywhere in the country. He went, whosoever has said that this doctor is good, he went everywhere. And this was a big, at this much big file he was having. And he was having severe pain. And you know what has happened? It affected his performance. He stopped performing. He was not performing. And you know, when he was not performing, there was a bank loan he took, and he became bankrupt. He started having other profession. He stopped that profession also, and finally he came back to Jaipur to his father, who is an IAS officer. Who was an IAS officer, and from Bombay, Jitendra told him that in North he wanted to come to any of the doctor from North, because it was so difficult from Jaipur to Bombay. So he said, sir, nearby, can I go somewhere? So Jitender asked me to see this patient. So he came to me. Now I saw him that he is a failed back syndrome boy, and I thought that this center is, I am treating only malignancy, so I should not see. And ethically, I have sent this patient to a doctor in the Delhi. And doctor in Delhi, what he did, he said, because the way he was expressing his pain, that it is severe numbness, tingling, everything, and so doctor, without, I don't know what they have done, but they have started ketamine burst therapy on this boy. The ketamine burst therapy, two settings they have given, and then they have sent back, because one burst therapy you give and then they send him home. So after second sitting, when he went there, so he stopped doing his activity. He was not catheterizing himself. He was bedwetting at the age of 30 years. He was not manually evacuating. His father was evacuating his bowel. And he was seeing the ghost. And he used to think that my mother is a ghost and she will kill me. And something like this, he used to behave very, very irrelevant behavior was there. So one day I went to Jaipur to conduct a workshop at Mahavir Cancer Center, and he came to me and he said that, doctor, I came to you in North and you have sent to me a doctor where they have given this therapy, and after this therapy my boy condition has become worse. He used to evacuate himself, he used to catheterize himself, he used to do bowel, he used to remove, empty his bowel himself. Now he is not doing, and I am doing this. See the condition of, and I saw the boy, he was in a very bad condition. I saw the mother, I felt very, very bad. I felt that this is my moral responsibility, that because he is a non-cancer pain, I have sent him. And I was not sure that what mistake I did is with this boy. So what I told him, that Monday I am reaching to Delhi, please come to Delhi. I admitted him with the due permission of all the authority, that I am admitting one non-cancer pain in the hospital. I admitted him. I asked one of my resident to take the full history. The resident, I said that even if it takes 5 hours, you have to take the full history and give me whole history in one page. So she brought the history in one page, and then we talked to him for 4 hours. And what I saw, that there was a major psychological component in this world. Major psychological. He, about the girlfriends, about the personality disorders, about the taking steroids because he wanted to remain very fit, and all sorts of problems. So I contacted Professor of